macOS is a great operating system, but there are some settings and features that are useless and just interfere with my work. Like, what if I told you you need to stop using the full screen mode because it makes you work slower? Now, I don't know if this is just me, but whenever I use a browser, I like searching up images, and it's just way better being able to drag these images onto this area on my desktop like this for easy access, so I can drag it into any app I want easily, especially when working with multiple windows. Look, I even use it when I'm editing my videos. But how to Mac, that's just one specific use case. I'm sure you still use full screen when using other apps. Okay, you have a point. I still use it when I play games, but I do also have work most of the time, and I like being able to multitask with multiple windows, which is impossible with full screen. If you didn't agree with me on that one, I bet you'll agree with me on at least one of the 7 more macOS settings and features that I think are kind of useless, that I think you should stop using, and the solutions I use. Do remember that this is just my way of doing things. You don't have to listen to everything I say, but please do still consider watching the whole video because I might end up helping you out. The next one is a bit of a hot take, but bear with me here. Another feature that I think you shouldn't use is the Launchpad. I always use my trusty Spotlight tool to find my apps because it's faster for me to type them all out, and it is way less distracting than having to go to the Launchpad and seeing all these other apps' icons. Fine, sometimes I use it to access apps that I don't exactly remember the name of, but that doesn't really happen often. It also makes it easier to find these random utility apps, but who even uses those? I mean, have you ever heard of or used the Color Sync utility? Yeah, me neither. Sorry to the one person that actually uses this. Stage Manager was added as a new feature in macOS Ventura that's supposed to enhance productivity. However, some users dislike this feature, and I think this Reddit thread summarizes why. It's very easy to forget what spaces you have, and you can't even have 2 windows at once, making multitasking a nightmare. One user even allegedly had an aneurysm trying to read this explanation. I don't think it's bad to that point, and of course I'm sure there are some users that enjoy this, but this feature doesn't help me personally. I also enjoy using Mission Control more, so I can handle multiple windows and desktops with just a swipe of my trackpad, as well as the Command Tab App Switcher. Okay, I know I just said I use my Spotlight to find all my apps, but I lied. I actually use Raycast, which is basically an upgraded version of the Spotlight. It comes with everything that the Spotlight does and more, like a clipboard manager, a built-in AI, an emoji picker, a better calculator, and Windows management, along with useful extensions created by the community for nearly every app and situation. This one has more to do with what you like. Natural scrolling makes the touchpad like an iPad touchscreen, where you swipe up to scroll up. I personally use this for my trackpad, but I have it turned off for my mouse using this app called Linear Mouse, link in description. Now I know it's not a feature, but Safari comes by default when you buy a new Mac. I used to use it back when I was completely new to my Mac, but I soon realized it isn't that good. I didn't really like the UI, and I found Google Chrome, another browser that uses Chromium, which is basically the standard now on the internet, so a lot of things run better on Chrome. As this Reddit user put it, websites are usually more optimized for Chromium, and more devs develop Chrome extensions since they're almost a monopoly in the browser space. Arc is the browser I use now, because it's also based on Chromium, and has a great vertical tab bar and great features. I don't have much to say about the next one, but I still dislike it. It's the dock magnification feature. I mean, it's not too bad, but I don't usually have that many items in my dock, so I can find them easily anyways. And I find it kind of distracting, so I've turned it off. Hot corners are in both of my tips and tricks videos, because it's a really useful feature, allowing you to access stuff really quickly. But there's one situation where I hate them. Remember when I mentioned that I only use full screen when playing games? Well, the hot corners sometimes get really annoying when I accidentally put my cursor down in a corner and the notes app comes up. Now I was considering turning it off until I found out that if you press the command key while configuring the hot corners, you can make it so it only appears when you're pressing the command key as well. It also works with other keys like option and control. Anyways, if you didn't know hot corners were a thing, then this video is for you, showing you some more great Mac features.